In the heart of Africa, where the sky touches the earth, our journey to conquer the roof of Africa has been nothing short of extraordinary. Throughout this arduous journey, we face obstacles that tested the limits of human endurance. We've laughed, we've cried, and we've learnt what it truly means to persevere. And though we had to say goodbye to one of our own, our resolve to reach the summit remains unshaken. Now, as we stand on the brink of our final ascent, the peak beckons us. Testament to the human spirit. Join us for our grand finale of our Kilimanjaro journey, where dreams and destiny collide. This is an Expedition Doctor's Kilimanjaro journey, the final ascent. As we pressed on through the night, the frigid air biting our faces, but eventually we caught up with the rest of the team and managed to get our well-deserved rest. Boy, does resting your legs feel good when you've had a walk like that. We rest another night, and before you know it, the sun is out again. It's morning time, and with a healthy big breakfast, it's time to continue the trek. So we're at 4,000 meters above sea level. Altitude sickness is taking its toll. With every single step, we fought against the thinning air, knowing that the key to success was acclimatization. As Joe the guide tells us, we are following the golden rule of Kilimanjaro climbing: walking high and sleeping low. It's a technique that allows our bodies to adapt to the decreasing oxygen levels, reducing the risk of altitude sickness. Even though I got new kit at the market before we started climbing, I was still walking in Puma Sports Direct trainers because they had no proper walking boots. This is fine for now, but later this could cause a lot of problems. I need proper walking boots if I'm gonna summit Mount Kilimanjaro. But altitude is an unrelenting adversary, affecting our physiology in ways we can't ignore. Reduced oxygen levels in the blood, increased heart rate, and the body's struggle to maintain proper oxygen saturation. To keep our energy up, we had to consume extra calories, despite the reduced appetite that often accompanies altitude sickness. Hydration was equally crucial. We drank liters of water to replace the fluids lost to higher breathing rates and altitude in diuresis. But how does this work? At higher altitudes, you wee more, meaning you lose lots of fluid, and this is due to the pH of the urine. But as we pushed our bodies to the limit, blisters became an expected challenge. Basic blister care became a daily ritual, ensuring we could keep moving forward.
When you pop the blister and you've made it sterile, you've cleaned it all up, put some dermal powder on to dry up the area.
Dermal powder
works perfectly.
As altitude sickness symptoms got worse, vomiting and pounding headaches were the common symptoms. We turned to a secret weapon of science, medicine, and maybe even magic: a medication called Diamox. Diamox is amazing, but how does it work? Diamox, also known as acetazolamide, helps prevent and alleviate altitude sickness by promoting better oxygen utilization in the body. Essentially, Diamox helps your body to adjust to the lower oxygen levels at high altitudes, reducing the risk and severity of altitude-related discomfort. It's all to do with the acidity of your blood and what that tells your brain to do, which can then alleviate symptoms of altitude sickness such as headache, dizziness, and nausea. As we inched closer to our goal, we learned that conquering Kilimanjaro wasn't just about physical strength, but also about understanding the science of altitude and about taking care of our bodies.
Good morning indeed. This is day 4. Of our trek. Everyone's just woken up. We're around 3,900 feet at Barranco camp, and we're ready to get up some breakfast and to continue our trek. We're going to be rock scrambling today. We're going to be scrambling on some rocks. I'm not sure what that means, but I'm excited to find out. Rock scrambling.
As we continued our ascent towards the summit of Mount Kilimanjaro, tension hung in the crisp thin air. The penultimate night was upon us, and nerves danced in our hearts like shadows on the mountainside. Just when we needed it most, we reached a breathtaking vantage point above the clouds. Amidst the beauty of this moment, a surprise awaited us. Ronaldo, one of the medical team members, began to drop a rap.
Spitting lyrics on a mountain.
His rhymes carried the weight of our journey, lifting it to the heavens, and for a moment we were transported away from the physical and into the realm of awe and wonder and beauty, serenaded by his words, beat, and rhythm. With newfound determination and unity, we knew that the final climb to Mount Kilimanjaro was within our grasp. As we arrived at Motamburu Kitendeni in the early afternoon.
So we made it. Ronaldo, we made it.
We made it.
So I just asked him, is he even tired at all in any way?
Yeah.
And He said no, that he's not feeling it at all, one bit.
Yeah.
Like, wow, that's incredible.
There was a surprise waiting for me that lifted my spirits higher than the looming peak of Kilimanjaro. A special delivery had miraculously made its way to the remote campsite, courtesy of Ethiopian Airlines. My kit, my trusted gear, and the very essence of my comfort on this challenging climb had arrived. There, neatly packed and untouched, were my clothes, my underwear, and perhaps the most crucial of all, my well-worn walking boots, a testament to my countless journeys and the foundation of my confidence on this monumental climb. The night before our daunting summit climb of Kilimanjaro was a flurry of preparation. Aware that our journey to the summit would commence at the stroke of midnight, the looming darkness held the promise of cold, unseen challenges, and the need for meticulous preparation was paramount. Joe, our expedition leader, gathered us around the fading sun, cast long shadows on the mountain. He emphasized the most daunting aspects of the summit climb with the rapid altitude gain and the biting cold. Frostbite was a very real threat, and we had to bundle up and embrace ourselves for the challenge ahead. Everyone dispersed to reflect and prepare. I found myself running a makeshift medical clinic once more, tending to aches and pains and concerns as best I could, offering advice and treatment. Unbeknownst to the others, amidst the medical dealings with fellow climbers, I was grappling with my own doubts. Imposter syndrome began to creep in. Could I really do this? I'm the doctor after all. I have to be sure. Instead of drowning in anxiety, I focused on what needed to be done, ensuring our medical supplies were in order and our oxygen tanks were full. The time came to retire to our sleeping bags, but the cold, moonlit night brought an unexpected sensation. Pins and needles, also known as paresthesia, tingling in my feet. Panic surged as I wondered if it was a blood clot, a DVT, or something more sinister affecting blood flow to my feet. Why have I got pins and needles at 5,000 meters up a mountain in my feet in the middle of the night? Pins and needles which were actually getting worse. Then, amidst the turmoil, clarity emerged. It was Diamox, acetazolamide. The tingling feet were a known side effect experienced by many before. I breathed a sigh of relief, grateful that I had considered all the possibilities. I closed my eyes, knowing that the journey ahead was going to be filled with challenges, both seen and unseen. But we were determined to face them alongside the brave souls who had embarked on this extraordinary expedition. The night of Kilimanjaro's summit had begun, and our journey illuminated only by the faint glow of our headlamps. The rocky, perilous terrain challenged our every step, while the bone-chilling cold seeped into our weary bones. The Action Challenge team sang songs, their voices resonating in the darkness, propelling us forward. 3 hours into the climb, I dropped back to assist a struggling climber.
You sure you're doing so well?
Yeah.
You're doing so well.
I just want to sleep.
She allowed me to slow my pace, I think I needed it, and together we pressed on. Altitude sickness cast its cruel shadow, nausea and drowsiness crept in, but we kept pushing forward, our bond growing stronger with each step. It was the two of us and some kind porters from the Action Challenge team as everyone else surged ahead. That was the best thing to do because we didn't want everyone else to slow down and get cold and possibly get frostbite. When it felt like all hope was lost, a glimmer of hope emerged on the horizon. The sun was rising as we approached Stellar Point. The rest of the team stood waiting, their cheers and songs like a beacon of encouragement. We were so close, yet we seemed so far because the grip of altitude sickness was gripping us and biting us and hurting us. But we pressed on, nearing the summit together.
Hey.
At the top, we celebrated our triumph with hot ginger in cups for us to drink. Our voices joined in songs of joy and accomplishment. For Lionade, the challenge was won, and the summit had been reached. But for me, there was a side quest that I had to complete. Ronaldo, my trusted medical porter, accompanied me on the final leg of the journey. It was just the two of us, and we faced the challenging path that led to the pinnacle of Africa, Uhuru Peak. We pushed on, and against all odds, we triumphed. We were at the highest point in Africa. I closed my eyes and had to thank God for this beautiful, inspiring moment. It was real and we were here and it was worth it. As we descended from the peak, our spirits were high and a sense of camaraderie enveloped us. At the foot of the mountain, a jubilant party awaited, celebrating our incredible achievement. As we stand here at the end of our extraordinary journey on Kilimanjaro, the lessons learned resonate deep within our hearts. Teamwork, driven by the hearts filled with determination and vision, has been our guiding star. It's a reminder that when we come together with a common why, there's no challenge that's too great. There's no mountain that's too high. The Lion Aid Lion Hearts have taught us that the true essence of any adventure lies not in the destination, but in the steps we take to get there. And so, as we bid a farewell to Kilimanjaro, let's carry these lessons with us. For it's these qualities that make every journey, every challenge, and every endeavor truly remarkable. We leave Kilimanjaro not just as conquerors of a mountain, but as conquerors of our own limits, with hearts as strong as lions. The only question left is, what mountain in your life are you going to climb next? Thanks for watching, and as always, stay fly.